Do we want an after session, or are you really, really busy?
We can do a quickie after session. No more than maybe 15 minutes.
Well, that's one heck of a quickie.
Yeah.
I blame school.
I have to have 10 minutes worth of information for my presentation, which,
that
if I assume each PowerPoint slide, I can probably expand to about 30 seconds worth of material, mm-hmm. which means I need to have 20 slides for 10 minutes worth of talking.
Nice.
So I need to get to 20 slides. I think right now I'm sitting at 9. So I still have a little ways to go before I, you know, hit 10.
Mm-hmm.
10 minutes worth of stuff. And once I have 10 minutes worth of stuff, I can stop. So between now and Tuesday morning, that's how long I have to finish my presentation.
You'll be
which
fine.
Which, I should be able to do that. I'm not necessarily worried about that. It's the perfectionist in me trying to make it perfect.
Exactly.
Where it doesn't need to be perfect, and we've actually explicitly been told that basically this is just a test to make sure you can get up in front of people and talk.
Mm.
Obviously, I've been doing this for 2 years. I don't have a problem with this. I have been teaching at ACON for the last 4 years.
Years, yeah.
Clearly, I have no problem teaching in front of large crowds of people.
You'll be fine.
It's a mental thing.
It's all mental. I understand completely. I'm with you. And 10 minutes is a lot to get through on one subject if you're not, like, changing things up.
Or if it's not a subject about which you are an expert and can pull out facts out of your rear.
Which is why I will never teach a wig panel, because it'll be like, meh. I know how to style one, basics, and to cut one, basics. I can spike. Okay, there's 20 minutes, and I'm done. Now, what I was going to tell you is that our paints and our dyes are in. I actually even got a brand new brush kit just for these silk dyes.
Nice.
Without actually explicitly talking about what our costumes are, I'm going to talk about what our costumes
Thank you.
Are. And then
it's like,
our,
wait, these are secret.
And then the fabric that I got that I'm going to use for one piece of it should be coming in by Tuesday, so I'll try to have a swatch of it for you to feel it on Hobbit Days.
My
to feel
gracious.
It and rub up on it. So I got the ones that you wanted, but I also got some extra silk dyes. In the colors that you wanted and I wanted, just so we can kind of test with it. Cause I really want to... Some of the
ideas
we have
another viewer. Hi, other viewer.
Hi, other viewer. And if there's any comments, I haven't seen any, so...
Okay. Yeah, YouTube changed up their comments thing, so it's a little more awkward.
It's very awkward.
For our listeners who are still around for the after session, I have never worked with silk. I've only worked with satin one time in my life, and it was crepe-backed satin.
Oh.
So this is a little bit daunting for me in
this
terms
is very
of
different.
working with nice fabrics. I've never done this. I have always been basically on so much of a budget that I have only ever used basically broadcloth or cotton variations of it. I mean, I've used things like twill or poplin, but it's always just basic cotton or polycotton because it's cheap. And I can get a lot of it for a good price.
Mm-hmm.
And it's quick, you know, it's quick to work with. It's very consistent. I don't have to worry about dyeing it. It comes in lots of colors. I can machine wash it, that sort of thing. That's basically all my cosplays have ever been, is that stuff. So now I'm sitting here, and we have this harebrained idea to suddenly do this paired cosplay, which started as a joke, incidentally. It was
totally
never actually supposed to happen. It's like, oh, hey... Why don't we do this? Tee-hee, evil devil face.
LOL.
And then it was like, and it was
why
like,
don't we?
You know what? Let's do this. And it just went from there into this
adding
massively.
On, like, we could put lights on it. And it's like, oh my god.
It's like we can make it. Of course, if it has amber involved, it will light up.
It will light up.
I'm sitting there going, okay, how do I make this light up? Okay, hey, I know how I can make it light up. Oh, hey, all my components are on sale for Black Friday. Let's get some components to make everything light up. Okay. And Belle's like, okay, let's get these nice fancy fabrics. And oh, hey, they're on sale. Let's get some.
Get some.
Oh, hey, let's get some paints and dyes so we can, you know, make things dye. Okay, this is getting, like, we started here, and now we're, like, here.
It's like, it's the best of Amber and the best of Val kind of squished together into this costume madness.
It is a very mad costume, I admit. It will be epically awesome when it's done.
It will be.
But it's going to be a maddening costume in the meantime.
And like, neither okay. of us can really start it until after AllCon anyway.
More or less. I mean, we could start drafting patterns, but that's about it. We can't actually get any farther than that.
Yeah, and most of my patterns are already in my little kit that I bought, so it's most of it's ready to go. I gotta finish
mine
this first.
Although I am still going to draft it out of muslin.
Oh, of course.
I prefer having a pattern that I'm working from that I know fits.
Right.
Because, yeah. Well, at least now I have a duct tape dummy, so at least I can fit the upper part of it correctly. But I'm not doing a duct tape dummy for Down Under. I don't really need it.
I think you'll be fine. But incidentally, have you seen my monstrous petticoat that I posted on my page?
The last thing I saw posted on your page was a shiny thing. It looked gold?
Okay, not the gold one. No, this is my pink petticoat, which I'm going to see if I can try to... I'm going to try to squish this over. This thing is hilarious and awesome, and I blame Asia 150% for this idea.
Oh, okay. So well, Asia, if you're watching, shame on you.
It's your fault.
For...
So the basis of the petticoat is 100% accurate like it's supposed to be. It's great. But the back of Amidala's dress has this nice poof on it, so I added a lot of that. It doesn't do it justice, but there is a lot
of it tulle?
It's tulle and netting.
Okay. Actually, in the advanced sewing
great.
Class, for those who have not been able to watch the ANT panels, the cosplay panels that we filmed, you can find them on our YouTube page. In the advanced sewing panel, she had a pair of what almost looked like were pantaloons or breeches, bloomers, you know, the real poofy pants, and that's how she kept them poofy instead of having all the fabric, you know, slide down to the bottom with gravity and just kind of gather there. She kept them all nice and poofy with tooling, which I thought was really neat.
That's a great way of doing it, because if I went for a more traditional method, and this still works, I mean, I know a lot of prom dresses and ballerina dresses that are done like this. Maybe not as gathered as mine is, but I needed a concentrated poof, not an all-over poof. But there are ways of doing it with levels and levels of fabric, but my concern is that over time that they would get weighted down, especially with the giant-ass skirt that I've got going on. And an overskirt on top of that, and the jacket on top of it. It would just weigh the fabric down, and I'd lose the poof. This is a great alternative. It's cheap, it's quick, it's easy, and I know it's not going to deflate.
Right, because basically your only other option would be to put a hard frame underneath it of like some sort of mesh or wire, which can be uncomfortable at best.
I'm already wearing so much with this thing, and I'm trying to also keep it in with the Rebel Legion's costuming standards. She doesn't have a hoop skirt underneath it. It's a petticoat, so this seems like a good alternative to me. And it's very pink.
It works. It really does.
Yeah.
I have so many costumes I want to make next year. So many costumes.
And not enough time to do it.
And not enough time. I feel like I haven't had time over the last year. Has it only been a year? Wow.
Yeah.
It's only been a year since I've
been
in school.
Year.
But with the classes being accelerated, I've just had no time to work on cosplay. It's very, oddly enough, it is stressful to not be able to work on cosplay because then you have no outlet for your stress. So it ends up being stressful to not work on the cosplay.
It'll be okay.
I felt
you're almost
so
done.
Good working on this. I felt so good because I had an hour of just flood of creative bug. And then afterward I was like, now what?
It's a good
it's
outlet
like, okay,
for stress relief.
I want to go back to working on cosplay now.
And I understand completely. That's kind of what I did yesterday. I was like, I was having a crappy week at work, and having the day off to just sew and do whatever was like, this is perfect. This is just what I needed. Hey, I see chat finally.
Although, to be fair, I could have done that from work. I could have done that from work, but it would have been unpaid, which would have been uncool. And I did get some perks for going into the office yesterday.
You got free lunch.
Which was nice. one of them was free pizza. Yes, it was very nice. It would have been better if the pizza hadn't been all meat, because I don't think they realized I couldn't eat any of it. So I just peeled the pepperoni off and just had pepperoni-flavored pizza instead of pepperoni pizza.
Close enough.
It was as close as I was going to get, and I did not get food poisoning, so it couldn't have all been bad. It's like, okay, note for self for next time. Tell them you would like cheese pizza, because you cannot eat meat pizza. Oversight on my part. It was still free pizza, so I can't really complain.
All right, it's been quick and dirty. We actually did 20 minutes.
Well, we ended a little after 3.
Yeah.
So, yep, we're good. Now I can sit back and type up some more work notes and talk more about passwords for my PowerPoint presentation.
Woohoo! Party time! Not really.
No, not really.
I go back to sewing. Making more circles. I'm so sick of circles.
You enjoy that. I'm going to be sitting here listening to podcasts, at least. I can catch up on my podcast, yes.
That's a good way of going about it. Yep. I was watching Big Bang Theory yesterday, so there you go. Trade-off.
That works. All right. Stay warm, everybody.
Night, everybody.
Bye.